capable of committing genocide against us. Check out what he's doing to our brothers in Vietnam. Check out what he's doing in Vietnam. We must develop an undying love as is personified in Brother Huey T. Newton. If we do not do that, we will be wiped out. Our slogan will become, first, our people, then, and only then, me and you as individuals. Our people first. Our people first. The concept of a black man is one who recognizes his cultural, his historical, and the reach of his great ancestors who were the greatest warriors on the face of this earth. Africans. Many of our people's minds have been whitewashed. If a Negro comes up to you and you turn your back on him, he's got to run to the honky. We're going to take time and patience with our people because they're ours. They're ours. All of the Uncle Toms, we're going to sit down and we're going to talk. And when they slap, we're going to bow. And when they slap, we're going to bow. And we're going to try to bring them home. And if they don't come home, we're going to walk them. We have to recognize who our major enemy is. The major enemy is not your brother, flesh of your flesh, and blood of your blood. The major enemy is the honky and his institutions of racism. That's the major enemy. That is the major enemy. A lot of people in the bourgeoisie tell me they don't like Rap Brown when he says I'm going to burn the country down. But every time Rap Brown says I'm going to burn the country down, they get a poverty program. They get a poverty program. A lot of people say to me, we don't like the Black Panthers for self-defense, walking around with guns. I tell you now, if the hunkies in San Francisco take off the fighters who happen to represent the Black Panthers for self-defense, ain't nobody in this community prepared to fight right now. Everybody gets off. And that's what we have to understand today. So that everything goes out the window, we talk about survival. That's all. They can cut all that junk about poverty program, education, housing, welfare. We talking about survival, and brothers and sisters, we gonna survive America. We gonna survive America. We gonna survive America. Have each other for our survival. We have to have each other, from the revolutionary to the conservative. Our Black United Front is what we're about. Our Black United Front is what we're about. I want to read a statement that Brother Huey P. Newton wrote yesterday when I saw him in jail. He says, as the racist police escalate the war in our communities against Black people, we reserve the right to self-defense and maximum retaliation. Understand this concept. Understand this concept. When they off Brother Malcolm, we did nothing. If they off Brother Huey, we got to retaliate. We got to retaliate. We must retaliate. We must fight for our humanity. It is our humanity that is at stake. All we say, Brother Huey will be set free or else. Thank you.
America, black people are treated very much as the Vietnamese people or any other colonized people because we're used, we're brutalized, the police in our community occupy our area, our community as a foreign troop occupies territory. And the police are there not to, in our community, not to promote our welfare or for our security and our safety, but they're there to contain us, to brutalize us and murder us because they have their orders to do so. And just as the soldiers in Vietnam have their orders to destroy the Vietnamese people, the police in our community couldn't possibly be there to protect our property because we own no property. They couldn't possibly be there to see that we receive the due process of law for the simple reason that the police themselves deny us the due process of law. And so it's very apparent that the police are only in our community, not for our security, but the security of the business owners in the community, and also to see that the status quo is kept intact.
People aren't hip to that yet. They're not really aware of it. They know some shit's going on in this country somewhere. But a lot of people out there don't know where it's at. They think it's the black people doing it. That all those riots are causing my life to be miserable in all areas, you know. And they really haven't focused in on the fact that it's the pigs. And they're mentors, the people who control the pigs, the power structure, those bald-headed businessmen at the Chamber of Commerce, you see? They're not turning on to that power structure. They just know their life is becoming increasingly miserable for everybody. Yeah. But when they find out who it is that's causing the trouble, and who it is that's making life miserable, and who it is that's responsible for all their sons being murdered in Vietnam, when they get tuned into that, see, then they're all going to be just like the Panthers. Because this is what we're tuning into. We see what's going on, and it's just a terrible and foul situation. More and more people are turning on to that, you see? So, I think they're going to do the dog right here in Babylon.
When we first started, we had a police alert patrol, and we would patrol the community. If we saw the police brutalize anyone, we put an end to this. Usually, the police wouldn't brutalize anyone if we were on hand because we were armed. And if the police arrested the individual, we'd follow him to the jail and bail the individual out, whether he was a Panther or not. And we would gain many recruits like this. So, therefore, the community started to say that, well, these people are really concerned about our welfare.
I think the basic reaction to a cat that like experiences a Panther, I don't mean who sees a guy go by in a black jacket or a beret. I mean a guy who sees a Panther in action with their lives on the line. When he sees that, that's the end of it. You know, like he's either scared to death or he's going to never commit no more crimes, do nothing wrong. You know, he's going to jaywalk. Or else he comes down and comes around and says that he can dig it, you see? You don't find a guy, black cat, just remain the same after really seeing the Panthers. The guys on the block out there, man, they never have been too impressed by America, you know, by what's been happening to them. They're not impressed by that. They don't stand in fear of the cops. And this is the reason, one of the reasons why the Panther Party focused on the cops. Because the cops are out there and they're...